just ensure that you have made your own preparation as to where you are going to be arriving into. Maybe that's where you'll be staying. You should have booked accommodation. You don't want to be that person that is left stranded at the airport by a family member that refused to take their calls. Hey guys, you're welcome to my YouTube channel. If you are new on this channel, you're beautifully welcome. Please hit the subscribe button down below and be sure to turn the post notification bell on. And if you're a returning subscriber to this channel, thank you so much for always watching my videos. You guys know the vibe. Give this video a thumbs up and leave a comment down below. Don't forget to share with your friends as well. In today's video, I'll be talking about factors to consider before choosing that province. So you are moving into Canada now and you want to decide on which or what province to move to. There are some factors you need to consider before you decide on where to move to. Ultimately, it's your decision as to where you choose to live. However, it's going to be very important for you to take some time to do some research on which province, except you are moving into Canada as a provincial nominee, or you are moving based on other provincial related programs that you have to settle in those specific provinces. Aside from that, you have to decide on where you want to move to. Canada is big and large, so you can't just live anywhere. You have to choose, okay? So these are some of the factors you need to consider when deciding to move to a province. Without further ado, let's jump right into the video. So the first thing I have on my list is family or relative. Family or relative is actually very, very important. If you know anybody or if you have a family friend or relative that could help you integrate well into that city or that could help you settle into Canada easily, you might consider moving to that province based on that factor. Just ensure that you have made your own preparation as to where you are going to be arriving into. Maybe that's where you'll be staying. You should have booked accommodation, maybe Airbnb or maybe hotels or a homestay or something where you would just have to stay. Make sure you have made your accommodation arrangements, and also transit from the airport. Make sure you have made your arrangement as to how you'll be moving from the airport to the hotel as well. If your family offers to help you, that's fine, but make your own arrangement. You don't want to be that person that is left stranded at the airport by a family member that refused to take their calls. We've seen that happen a lot, not once, not twice, not 10 times, so it's going to continue to happen. So make sure you have your plans. But if you have a family member in that province, it's definitely going to help you with settling in quickly. Number two on the list here is housing. So you want to consider moving to a province that has affordable housing. The rents are cheap, or maybe the opportunity of getting your own house in the future. You want to consider a province that is more affordable. The cost of housing and even cost of living in general varies from provinces to provinces. If you have more population in a particular province, it's definitely going to push the prices of things, and the cost of living in general, even housing as well, would be affected. So you want to look at the province that has a affordable cost of housing. The next thing I have on my list here is taxes. You know what it is. It is what it is. Moving into Canada, taxes, there are different kind of taxes that apply, but the ones that I'll be specific about in this video is the GST and HST tax. So Canada has the GST tax, which is goods and services taxes, and there is also PST tax. PST is the provincial taxes as well, and we also have HST. HST is the harmonized taxes. So each province has different rates that they charge for GST. So when you purchase something, how much taxes would you have to pay on that thing? All provinces in Atlantic Canada pay about 15% as HST, which I think is the highest in all of the provinces in Canada. And also the lowest we have is 5%, which is Alberta, and all three territories in Canada pay 5% GST as well. So let's put that to example. If you are buying something, let's say you're buying a pair of Nike sneakers for $100. If you are in Alberta, you'll be paying $100 plus 5%, which is going to be $105. But if you are in a province like Ontario, where we pay 13% as harmonized tax, that's HST, if you'll be buying that pair of sneakers in Ontario, so you'll be paying $113. That's like an example of what it is. So everything you buy here, you'd have to pay 13% in Ontario. If you are buying it in Alberta, you have to pay just 5%. So that's an example of what it is. You would also have to consider the rate of unemployment in that province before you move there. Look out for a province that has more prospect for your career. Look out for a province that has opportunities if you are into specific kind of jobs or specific kind of field. That way you would be more secured, or you'd be more guaranteed that you are less likely to experience unemployment or maybe being underpaid. And I think the province that has the lowest rate of unemployment in Canada is British Columbia. I looked that up, but you know, anything can change at any point in time. The fifth factor I have on my list is childcare. So you want to consider a province that has like maybe a subsidized cost for childcare, because childcare varies in different provinces. The cost of childcare varies in different provinces. For some are based on like low income earning group. Like if you are in province of Alberta now, you'll be getting government support if you are within the low income earning group. And the more your income goes up, the lesser you get from government for your childcare. But some other provinces has it as just subsidized, or maybe it's just general. It depends on what province. Every province has different rules that applies to them. The sixth factor I have on my list here is healthcare. Healthcare in general in Canada is free. It's free for everybody. But different provinces has different rules as to when you have access to the healthcare services. So in province of Ontario, for example, you can only access the healthcare system after 3 months of arrival. And not just 3 months of arrival, you have to have stayed in Ontario for 3 months, because you'll be asked to prove that you have lived here. You might use your maybe your driver's license, or maybe your a void check from your bank or something, just to prove that you have actually been living in Ontario. That's the only way you can get your health card after 3 months. But for provinces like Alberta, you can access the free healthcare system upon arrival, which is good. So if you are coming into Canada, say with your kids, or you know the kind of health, your health state, you would know if you would be needing healthcare immediately. Or maybe if you are even coming in as a pregnant woman and you know that maybe your due date would fall within the next 3 months, you definitely want to consider going to a province that would allow you have your child, because private healthcare is expensive. So you definitely want to consider a province that would give you free healthcare upon arrival. It depends on your situation, but that's also one of the factors you should consider as well. The last but not the least that I have on my list here is the weather. Weather condition in Canada is cold, like 100% fat. Canada's weather is one of the coldest in the world, and it's like cold all year round. There are sometimes we experience warmth. Of course, during summer it's warm, but different provinces has different levels as to how cold it is. So if you are someone that you don't like cold at all, or you can't cope in like very cold environment, you want to consider moving to a province like British Columbia, because it's really warm down there, and that's why you find more people going there as well. But if you don't mind the cold, maybe you are fine with minus 60 degrees. Sometimes it could go as low as minus 40 degrees, 45 in provinces like Manitoba, Yukon, or Nova Scotia. Those provinces get really, really cold. It could go as low as 45 degrees. So if you don't mind the cold, you can go to those provinces, provided you consider other factors and you've been able to weigh your option. Generally, regardless of how well you react to the cold, you still have to dress up for the weather and try to keep warm. So based on these factors that I have mentioned, just ensure you weigh your options, you do your own personal research, and decide on which province is best that will suit you before you come into Canada. Overall, whichever province you decide to live in Canada is fine. We have a very good centralized government system here, and everywhere in Canada is still beautiful. So regardless of where you choose to stay, regardless of what factor you look into, just make sure you do your personal research and move to that province. As well, you can also move to other provinces later on. Maybe along the line, you stay in Manitoba and you decide to move to Ontario later in the year. You can as well do that. There's no limit as to you moving to any province, provided you have your permanent residency and it's not limited to specific provinces. But I'm going to tell you that it's really, really, really a challenge moving from a province to another, because you'd have to get a different health card, you'd have to get a different driving license, you have to get like starting a new life. It generally is as good as moving to a new country on its own. So I hope this video would serve as a guide in the right direction and lead you on the right path as to choosing what province to move to. If there is any questions you would have for me regarding this video, please leave a comment down below. I'm more than happy to take your question. If you are yet to subscribe as well, please consider doing that right away. Hit the subscribe button down below. Just tap a little, pam, that's it. So hit the subscribe button down below and turn the post notification bell on as well, so you can get notifications each time I post a new video. That's pretty much it, guys. I'll see you guys in my next video. Stay confident. Bye bye. Take care.